I was born with congenital glaucoma, so I was diagnosed at 3 days old. I can see to certain distances depending on the day, because some days my eyes are okay, sometimes they're foggy. I can read large print, but not for a very long time because my eyes will get fatigueness. And then I can tell colors. I can't tell the difference between dark colors, so like dark purple, dark blue, black, brown, dark brown, they all look the same to me. They're all just black.
That's right. We're on live. We're gonna get this thing done one way or another. What's up to y'all?
I was born with congenital glaucoma, so I was diagnosed at 3 days old. I can see to certain distances depending on the day, because some days my eyes are okay, sometimes they're foggy. I can read large print, but not for a very long time because my eyes will get fatigueness. And then I can tell colors. I can't tell the difference between dark colors, so like dark purple, dark blue, black, brown, dark brown, they all look the same to me. They're all just black.
That's right. We're on live. We're gonna get this thing done one way or another. What's up to y'all?
As a parent, as a blind parent, what challenges have you run into that has made the task a little bit difficult, to actually, be a parent? Or if you have not run into any, talk to me about those as well.
Well, my number one thing would be transportation. If I could drive, we would probably, I don't know, like I was thinking about when this whole pandemic started, I was hearing about how sighted parents, they could just get in the car and just go for a ride. Like, they don't have to get out of the car. They could just go for a ride and do like window seating, like, touring outside. So, we can't do that. Like, we can't just jump in an Uber and go and ride around because it's going to be expensive. And, but not only that, even getting an Uber right now for a family of four is expensive because we have to get a bigger car. So I think that if we could drive, we definitely wouldn't be in the house as much. And then my children, they would be, I mean, they're okay, but they can get a little crazy towards the end of the day, especially if they've been in the house for a few days. They're used to going to school. So it's like now they're stuck at home with mom and dad, and they're like, I mean, we're going crazy, but they're going crazy too.
Okay.
And
Wait.
then
But you there have you at least come up with or have at any point in time come up with ways to to change basically the monotony of actually having the kids at home and you're at home, because sometimes I get like that too. I have a 6-year-old, and it's by me being totally blind, it's hella hard trying to be creative. Have you come up with any ways to be creative with your kids?
Yeah, so we try our best to go over to a family member because we live in an apartment. So we try to go over to a family member's house at least once or twice a week so they can just run around outside. And then we'll take them on walks. And then we've like being home with them has actually like given us the opportunity to watch them grow, because when they're in school, we kind of miss all of those important milestones most of the time because they're in school more than they're at home, if you think about it. So we've been able to teach our son his colors, and he's learning his alphabet. And my daughter, she's just like talking too much, and it's just she's like we're actually getting to see them grow into little people. So I think having that time outside and like teaching them, I mean, I didn't go to school to be a teacher, but I mean, it's basic stuff. They're only one in three, so it's not like I'm trying to teach them algebra or anything. So
Well, what do you say to people who have commented back in the day and speaking of the Breakfast Club situation about people who are visually impaired not being able to take care of kids? Because this was new to me. I did not know that there are blind parents who have kids. I don't know if you know, once they have, you know, once they have their kids, there's a situation whereby it has been brought to their attention that maybe the kids should be placed with someone else because they can't take care of kids. What's your opinion about that?
I don't agree with that at all, because I feel like some blind parents are better than sighted parents in some cases. As far as like me and my boyfriend, like we, you know, people are always wondering, like, how do you know what they're doing? We talk to our kids a lot. Like, and I think that's why our kids were so vocal from like at an early age. And my kids were even walking early. They were walking at 10 months. And so I think it's because we were always out walking with them. We always talk to them. And then we always touch them in some type of way. We have to touch them to make sure that they're not doing something they're not supposed to. And so I feel like blind people are more alert and like aware to what their kids are doing because they can't see. And like, you know, instead of like a sighted person, they could just glance over there across the room, but we can't. So we have to actually physically get up and touch them, you know, just to make sure that they're not in any danger.
That's a great point. And while you were speaking on touching, I was really visualizing in my mind that's what I do my little boy a great deal. So he hasn't gotten to the point. So with that, he hasn't started asking me why, but I honestly do that. So that's a great point.